Let's now talk a little bit about web content distribution networks, or CDNs. We'll first talk about what a CDN is and why a content provider might want to use one. We'll then talk about how server selection works in CDNs and how clients get redirected to the right server. So first of all, what is a content distribution network? It's an overlay network of web caches that's designed to deliver content to a client from the optimal location. Now, in many cases, optimal means geographically closest, but sometimes optimal is not the geographically closest cache, and we'll see some examples of when that's the case. CDNs are made of distinct, geographically disparate groups of servers, where each group can serve all the content on the CDN. These CDNs can often be quite extensive. Here is a global map depicting the deployment of the Google cache servers around the world, as mapped in a recent project by researchers at the University of Southern California. As you can see, these web caches can be quite extensive, and in many cases, there's a concerted effort to place caches as close as possible to users. Some CDNs are owned by content providers, such as Google, and others are owned and operated by networks, such as Level 3, Limelight, and AT&T. Still others, such as Akamai, operate independently. Non-network CDNs, such as Akamai and Google, can typically place servers in other autonomous systems, or ISPs. The number of cache nodes in a large content distribution network can vary. For example, in the Google network, the USC researchers found that there were about 30,000 unique front-end cache nodes. As of about 2 years ago, the Akamai Edge platform reported about 85,000 unique caching servers in nearly 1,000 unique networks around the world in 72 countries.